Feel free to check out my TeePublic after the video, and support me on Patreon. Watch till the end of the video for more. Hideaki Anno as a director, I'm sure, needs no introduction at this point. Whether it's his work on Gunbuster, Nadia, Evangelion, and Shin Godzilla, there's no doubt that he earned his place in popularity in Japanese pop culture. Especially thanks to his distinct directorial style, inspired by the likes of Kihachi Okamoto, Akiyoshi Soji, and Yoshiyuki Tomino. However, despite being widely known for his efforts in animation, not many really take a look at his live-action work. Sure, that has changed a little with Shin Godzilla, and is starting to change a little more with Shin Kamen Rider on the way. Plus, his live-action Cutie Honey does have a cult following. But while he's known for basically taking things from his youth and either doing his own take on the media or just straight up adapting it, it's usually stuff that he likes, with a blend of whatever emotional hardships he had endured. But there is a movie in his filmography that is purely about emotional hardship, and it is perhaps his greatest film that has yet to be topped. Shikijitsu, or The Ritual, would actually be Anno's second live-action film. Before this was Love and Pop, a film that confronted the disturbing perverted issues that lurk within Tokyo from the perspective of schoolgirls. And while Love and Pop was more so Anno making a statement about society, Shikijitsu is one that comes off as being personal. It is the story of a young director who meets a rather strange woman. Strange in the sense that she is completely carefree, unbound from the shackles of reality, or at least that's what it seems. Judging by her wide variety of outfits and her repeating that tomorrow is her birthday, the events of the film happen over a course of 33 days. As the film progresses, these two not only become more drawn to one another, but we, the viewer, are also met with sudden bursts of anxiety, as we see them in distress at points, clearly traumatized by whatever they had experienced prior to them meeting, especially the woman, which, at this point, it is clear that she no longer has a grasp on the world around her. But this film is far from a pretentious, life-sucks sob story. We see these two make efforts to help one another, being there by each other's sides through their emotional struggles, helping each other become stronger people. The film ends on the woman's actual birthday, December 7th, which also happens to be Ayako Fujitani's real birthday. Ayako Fujitani being the actress who plays the woman in the film, and you may remember her from the Gamera series. And Shikijitsu was even released on December 7th in 2000. The film was produced by Studio Kajino, which is a subsidiary of Studio Ghibli, which Anno has worked for in the past for films like Nausicaä. It was shot in Ube City in Yamaguchi Prefecture, Hideaki Anno's birthplace. Shikijitsu also happens to be based on a story named Tohimu, written by Ayako Fujitani. Fujitani heavily based Tohimu on her personal, real-life struggles, which are definitely present in the film, as the main character she plays was based on the effects of that. And if you know anything about Ayako and what she's been through, it adds another layer of sadness to her character. Anno would combine Fujitani's experiences with his own, as he also had his ups and downs in life. This would actually become a major role in Ayako Fujitani's career because of this, often hailed as her finest performance, alongside with her work in films like Tokyo, The Man from Reno, and I Will Make You Mine. Alongside Fujitani is filmmaker Shuji Iwai, in his only acting role to date. Iwai is an acclaimed filmmaker known for his calm atmospheric character dramas with notable films such as All About Lily Chocho, Love Letter, Hannah and Alice, and A Bride for Rip Van Winkle. Here, he is essentially Anno's self-insert, but that's not to demean his performance, as he works wonderfully with Ayako, and you certainly feel the stress these two have to overcome. Other members of the cast include Fujitani's abusive ex-boyfriend, played by Jun Murakami, her mother, played by Shinobu Otake, and more notably, the inner narration of the two main characters are performed by Megumi Hayashibara and Suzuki Matsuo. Shikijitsu boldly tackles numerous sensitive topics including depression, mental illness, suicidal thoughts, family struggles, toxic relationships, and loneliness. Even with the film's exaggerated visuals at times, it is very raw and real in many ways. As sad as the film gets, the film is also surprisingly hopeful. It's a movie that tells us that we are never truly defined by the demons that haunt us, as we all have the strength to overcome them, even if we struggle. And that is okay. That's what makes us human. It's a film so unique and distinct from other arthouse dramas in Japanese cinema.
Anno's directorial style, mixed with Yuichi Nagata's camera work and Takashi Kako's beautiful scoring, makes for a very emotional yet powerful experience. A more recent comparable film is Shinya Tsukamoto's Kotoko, starring Coco, which also deals with dark topics in a unique artistic manner. Funny enough, Coco sings the song at the end credits for Shigijitsu titled Raining. As a result, the film would go on to win an award for Best Artistic Contribution at the 13th International Film Festival in Tokyo, and would be considered a gem in Japanese cinema. Unfortunately, the film has yet to gain an international home media release. There was a DVD with English subs that was released in Japan, but has since then gone out of print. However, the film nowadays is available on Blu-ray with English subs on the Hideaki Anno live-action film collection from 1998 to 2004, which contains all of Anno's live-action works at the time. However, it's only available in Japan, but it is Region A for those living in those territories like the United States and Canada. And with all that being said, whenever you can, definitely seek this movie out. It deserves to be in the numerous conversations about how Evangelion and Shin Godzilla are Anno's masterpieces. In fact, go ahead and bring up Shigijitsu during those conversations, and see what people really know about Hideaki Anno. By the way, want to know something else? You should support the channel on Patreon if you like what you see. But what's in it for you? Why should you support me on Patreon? Well, for a single dollar, your name can appear at the end of every future upload and get access to my Discord server. Other than that, you can also get early access to videos, exclusive content, commissioned video requests, and receive a t-shirt of your choice from IT Public. Also want to give a very special thank you to Simon Sebsek and Dangbirds for becoming new patrons. Thank you all so much. And I want to give a very special shout out to Toku Titancast co-host Sean of Shots of Japanese Cinema for editing this video for me. Thank you so much, dude. You and Cole are amazing, and I am forever grateful. Feel free to like, share, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff, and this is Titan Goji, signing off.